Okay, we have considered the equation d cube y minus 4d square y plus dy plus 6y is equal to 0. So, while solving this, as I said, first we have to write in the auxiliary equation form. Then we have to find the roots of this auxiliary equation. We tried with 0, we tried with 1, but we didn't get the solution. And we were thinking about using minus 1, right? So, we will see what if it is minus 1. Whether we will get the value equal to 0. Okay, if I take minus 1, so minus 1 cube, minus 1, minus 4, minus 1 plus 6. So you can observe here, this is 6 minus 6 plus 6, clearly we will get equal to 0. So 1 root is nothing but m plus 1 is one of the root of the given auxiliary equation. Now we have to find the other roots. Clearly it is m cube, so 3 roots will be there. We got 1 root, we have to find the other 2. So I'll divide the given equation, that is m cube minus 4m square plus m plus 6 using the m plus 1. So here m cube is needed, so you will get m square. So m square, then m cube plus m square. So once again, changing the sign, this I have already explained while simplifying the previous equations. So minus minus, this gets, sorry, here it is m cube, so it gets cancelled. Here you will get minus 5 m square plus m. Once again, here it is m, I want minus 5 m square, so minus 5 m. So this becomes minus 5 m square minus, minus into plus is minus 5 m. So once again, when you change the signs, this get cancels, this becomes 6 m plus 6. So here I need 6 m, but here I am having only m, so plus 6. So you will obtain 6 m plus 6. Once again, when you change the signs, you will get 0. Okay, now we will simplify and write this. So I will get m plus 1 into m square minus 5m plus 6 is equal to 0. So one of the root is m is equal to, sorry, m plus 1. M is equal to minus 1. Now by solving this quadratic equation, we have to obtain the other two roots. So on multiplication, we have to get 6, and on simplification, we have to get minus 5. So clearly you can write it as M plus 1 into minus 5 and 6. So that is nothing but M minus 2, M minus 3 is equal to 0. Here 2 into 3, minus minus plus 6. So, you will get it as minus 5 also. So, m is equal to minus 1, m is equal to 2, m is equal to 3 are the 3 roots of the auxiliary equation which we have considered. Now, the thing is writing the general solution of this equation. So, therefore, general solution is how we can write y is equal to c1, a constant, into e power first root, that is minus 1 into x or minus x, plus c2 into e power the second one, that is 2x, plus c3 into third one, that is e power 3x. So if the roots are real and if the roots are distinct, then we can write the solution in this form, the general solution in this form, that is y is equal to c1 e power minus x plus c2 e power 2x plus c3 e power 3x. Now what if the roots are same? There are chances that we get the roots same here, 2 and 2 or 3 and 3, or we may get the same value of m, that is m, as we considered in the previous case, m1, m2, m3, so on up to mn are the roots. All that can be equal. So if all those are equal, then how we can write the general solution? Okay, I'll consider the equation of nth order f of d into y is equal to 0. Suppose the roots ym1, m2, m3, so on up to mn, all these are equal, and I'll represent using b. Suppose all the roots are equal, then how we can represent? This becomes d minus b whole power n into y is equal to 0. You know that this way I can further simplify and write d minus b whole power n into x to the power k into e to the power bx is equal to 0. Now all the roots are same, then how we can write the general solution? So we can write the general solution as, here y is equal to, here c1 e power minus x, here they, those are distinct, so we considered only c1, c2, c3. Here when they are same, we write c1 plus c2x plus c3x square plus so on, it continues till how much you are having the repeated roots. Here I am having till n, so I will write here cn x power n. If I am having till n minus 1, cn minus 1 up to x minus n into e power bx. So if I am having the repeated roots, the general solution is written as c1 plus c2x plus c3x square, here cn x power n minus 1 into e power bx. So we'll solve one problem and see how to write the general solution when there are repeated roots. Okay. Problem, it is given as solve d square plus 8d plus 16 into y is equal to 0. So we'll solve this problem and find whether it is having the repeated roots, and if yes, then how to write the general solution, we'll see in our next class. Thank you.